Oh my god. No. Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Pokemon Colosseum. It feels like it has been so long since I recorded this, even though in reality... Well, actually for you guys it's only been a few days since you saw the last episode, but I recorded that quite a while ago, so... It is good to be back. Anyways, last time, we finished everything. We purified all of the shadow Pokemon, as you can see right there. And, we were pretty much done. The main story is done. And we are here now at Mount Battle, because we have a Mount Battle challenge to take care of. That's what we're gonna be doing from now on. Of course, like I mentioned last time, if you didn't see that, Colosseum is now going to be weekly, every Monday at 2 PM Central. You'll get a new episode of Colosseum, and it will be a new part of the Mount Battle Challenge, so... That's what's going on, and we're here in story mode, taking on the regular Mount Battle in here to start off with. Now, before we go in, I want to check our items, see what we have. I think we're gonna be good. We have a lot of stuff, we don't need any Pokeballs. Okay. And actually, once again, before we get started, I want to let you guys know of something that I forgot to mention in the last episode, or the episode before that. I wanted to plug this, and I forgot to. This series isn't the first time I've done a Pokemon Colosseum video, or the first time I've been involved in a Pokemon Colosseum video. If you check the description, I'll leave a link to a video on my friend Ryan's channel, where we played some Pokemon Colosseum and XD battles on the big screen using like my Leaf Green team and stuff like that. It's a very old video from quite a while ago, but I watched over it again recently and I figured I'd let you guys know that that exists. So the link to that will be in the description, and it's definitely a fun watch if you've enjoyed this series. Anyway, before we get started here, let's take a quick look at the team. We have Nico the Espeon right here. Level 65, holding the Twisted Spoon, synchronized for the ability, with Helping Hand, Reflect, Protect, and Psychic. We have Joey the Feraligatr, level 65, holding the Mystic Water, Torrent for the ability, of course, with Dragon Claw, Hydro Pump, Rain Dance, and Surf. We then have Hedwig the Noctowl, level 70, holding the Experience Share, Keen Eye for the ability, with Dream Eater, Fly, Hypnosis, and Shadow Ball. We then have Donovan the Ampharos, level 66, holding the Quick Claw, Static for the ability, Light Screen, Thunder, Thunderbolt, and Thunder Wave. His moveset really hasn't changed at all. Tyson the Hitmontop, level 65, holding the Black Belt with Intimidate for the ability, Brick Break, Detect, Focus Energy, and Triple Kick. And then finally, Ryuko the Grand Ball, level 65. Holding the Amulet Coin, once again with Intimidate for the ability, with Earthquake, Fire Blast, Sludge Bomb, and Toxic. So, without any further ado, let's jump in here. Thank you for waiting! Training will resume on Mount Battle. Let's go ahead and challenge this. Would you like to start a new challenge, or would you like to resume an ongoing one? New challenge. Hope you do well on your knockout challenge, let's go. Wes, go for it. Bye, Rui! Yeah, Rui doesn't even get to come with us. Welcome back to Mount Battle. Actually, I don't know if we were able to continue from number 10 where we got to in the story mode, but we're gonna start a new one anyway. Welcome to Mount Battle! We want you and your Pokemon to go all out on training here. Let's begin. Now, the first thing you're gonna notice here, one, that fade, it had a Pokeball in it, it was great. First thing you will notice, we are very overleveled. Like, hella overleveled here. This is a level 15 and a level 16. Yes, I'm still gonna show this. I know I could just speed this all up, but we're not gonna do that. That's not something we're gonna do. We're gonna go through Mount Battle and show every aspect of it. The levels, of course, get a lot higher as we go on. It's gonna get a lot tougher, but they kind of expect you to challenge this as you're going through, I think. So, I guess they expect you to challenge the first areas of Mount Battle, like, at the beginning of the game, or when you first get to Mount Battle, but we're doing it all in one go. So, this first video, we're just gonna decimate absolutely everything. Like, we're just gonna, look at that, 46 experience points. And that's the first battle done. We're just gonna decimate everything with Surf, more than likely. You're a worthy challenger! I'm also insanely over-leveled, Mr. Cool Trainer. My hat's off to you, but the road ahead is long and arduous. Put all your effort into it. His hat actually is off because he's not wearing a hat. Let's go to the next zone. For some reason, it makes us select yes. Pokemon are living beings of charming elegance. They are worthy of the sophisticated moi. You didn't even let me get close to you, dude. Rich boy Cius. Of course, a rich boy. Sunken and Hoppip. All right. This is... We're gonna just decimate everything here. As I've said many times, but if you're wondering why it is that I'm even wanting to do this and not just wanting to speed through everything, of course, you're not required to watch these episodes if you don't want to watch us just slowly go through stuff and slowly destroy everything. But I don't know, it feels more authentic for me to do it this way. Plus, we're making this weekly, so it's just one of these every Monday. So, you know, it's different. I don't know. I don't think I've ever seen anyone really do this on YouTube. I mean, I'm sure someone has. But we're going to be doing... Actually, I don't think I mentioned this in this episode yet. We're going to be doing 10 areas per episode. So, Mount Battle will be done in 10 episodes. At least this Mount Battle. Like I've said before, there's three of them. And that's the second battle done. My elegant charm. Yeah, your Sunkern and your Hoppip. Kinda suck. Now, I must admit... Now you must admit, was not my defeat a marvel of pure elegance, non? Stop talking weird. I don't English good. There isn't a thing that I don't know about Pokemon. I know it all. So you'll know, Mort, that you're about to get blown back by my Feraligatr. Even though you have an Electrike. Okay, Igglybuff. I got you in Pokemon Go. Could you tell your friend Cleffa to hurry up and hatch? Because I only need a Cleffa and an Elekid. And then I have them all. And then I have all the Gen 2. Well, and I need Togetic, but I've been walking my Togepi for about 40 kilometers, so I'll get it eventually. Let's discuss Pokemon Go, why not? Because we're just going to be slowly going through and killing all these poor little Pokemon. And there goes Igglybuff. Its head, like, popped. That was a little strange. Where do I begin? I've been playing Pokemon Go daily for quite a while now, because... For those of you who don't know, I don't recall if I mentioned this in my January update video. I made one of my Don't Break the Chain things for this year to be to walk for at least 30 minutes a day. Like outside, or exercise for at least 30 minutes is what I wrote. But I've been making it walk outside for 30 minutes a day. And I've done it so far. I've done it for 15 days. Of course, this video is going up on the 16th. I'll be doing this on the 16th later today. Essentially what I've been doing is after work, I've been going out for half an hour, walking around the parking lot of the nearby, like, shopping area. And it's a parking lot that's full of Pokemon, so I've been playing Pokemon Go as well. I bought one of the Christmas event bundles in Pokemon Go, so I got a whole bunch of incense and a whole bunch of, lucky eggs. So I've been popping an incense and a lucky egg, which last half an hour, and then walking around for half an hour, catching a bunch of Pokemon, getting a bunch of experience points, and, getting exercise while I'm at it, so... I just wanted to mention that I've been doing that. It's a lot of fun. I just hit level 25 yesterday. So... We're moving up in the world, boys. Only problem is... I don't have many Pokeballs, and I don't really want to spend any more money on the game yet. I've spent too much money on the game. So, I think I'm probably just gonna make today's walk a Pokestop grind. I'll have to go somewhere else where there's actually a bunch of Pokestops, but I need to make it a Pokestop grind to actually get some Pokeballs back. How uncouth of you! Shut up, you're like 4 years old. Alright, another suggestion I'd gotten for this series for Mount Battle is that I should live stream it, and I would have done that, but I have a terrible internet connection that is unstable and I don't have Ethernet, so Yeah, oh, look at that Pokemon Stadium Vulpix. You can kind of tell when the models have come from Pokemon Stadium. I mean, Vulpix looks a little bad. And Togepi's right here, like, hey, you've been walking with me for far too long. In fact, I'm gonna put a picture on screen. I'll take the screenshot of it right now while I'm here, while I remember to. In Pokemon Go, if you have Togepi as your buddy and you're walking with Togepi, your guy holds it. Your trainer holds the Togepi, so you're not actually walking the Togepi. You're just carrying it around. So I'll put that on screen right now because we just beat his Pokemon. It is incredibly cute, and I love it. You found another groove. I didn't read your dialogue beforehand, so I have no idea what you're talking about. I'm still just trying to take this screenshot that you'll have already seen. There we go. And got it. Okay. So another thing, I'm just going to keep talking about Pokemon Go because it's just what I've been doing most recently. How come... Did you just say I don't look very strong? How come they haven't implemented a friends list yet? I feel like that's something they should do, so you can actually add friends. I don't know what you would do with it, and what having friends would really allow you to do on the game, not just in general, but I don't know. I want a friends list, because you see all your friends on Twitter or whatever posting the screenshots, and you see the username. It's like, I want to add them, but you can't. Also, there is a Magikarp on our screen right now. We're going to be seeing... That's a good thing about Mount Battle. We're going to be seeing a lot of Pokemon that you wouldn't normally see in the main story. These guys tend to use a lot of different stuff. Hence the Magikarp. I was going to say, if it lived... And there goes Zubat. You, sir, I'm tired of seeing you. I have like 200 Zubat candy. Anyway. So yeah, that's my little Pokemon Go rant, I guess. It's not even really a rant. It was just me explaining stuff about it and what I've been doing with it, but it's a lot of fun, and if you guys think Pokemon Go is dead, you're unfortunately incorrect. Lots of people still play it. And it's very active. They're always doing new updates and stuff, so... Yeah, it's a lot of fun. And they upped the spawn rates of different types of Pokemon in like rural areas, so I've been finding a lot better stuff recently, just nearby. I mean, I still find an abundance of Pidgey and Rattata, Weedle, Caterpie, Venonat, and Paris, but you know, they've made them better. You can find rarer stuff. Like, there's a Pokestop near my house. It's like a 5-minute drive from my house. It is a Magmar spawn, and the other day it was a Jinx spawn. But for like a week now, it's just been Magmar, so... Can't complain about that. And there goes Poochyena. And Swinub, I do not think you are living, good sir. Goodbye. Look at his little feet. That was adorable. And okay. Now, I'm gonna look something up really quick, because I don't recall... Well, I don't recall what I'm about to look up. Nope. Let's just search Mount Battle. Mount Battle. Sorry if I bumped my microphone for a second there. She'll have to redo her studies. Okay, then. Mount Battle, okay. You there! Are you working on your bot every day? Why, yes. I just got through explaining this. I want to know if they get more than 2 Pokemon each. Okay, yeah, they do. By the end of the area... Oh, crap. We're actually way more overleveled than I thought we were. Holy crap. You know what, that's fine. I don't even really care at this point, because once we get into the other mount battles, the levels of the Pokemon in there are decided by your level. So, it doesn't really make a difference. But, yeah, we're very overleveled, but trainers do start to get more than 2 Pokemon. Wait, he has Water Resolve. This Wooper is going to live. Really? Wait, hold up. Oh, yeah, there's a trainer. Apparently there's a trainer on the exterior? And then you can rematch them? Did we fight a yeah, the athlete, Adel? Apparently there's an athlete outside, but look, someone actually... Well, they didn't even do damage. Well, wait, they did do Oopa did 1 point of damage. Alright, Dragon Claw then. Even though Nico's gonna go first. Yeah, apparently you can rematch the trainer outside. I didn't actually realize that. We may have to do that at some point, but we'll see. Anything else? I mean, I know you don't have anything else, but maybe... Maybe you want to break the code and send out like a Rayquaza. Explosive energy! Yes, sir. You know, if anything had to hit us, I'm happy it was a Wooper. Anyway, moving on to Zone 9. Hello there, miss. 444, do you think you could take this old woman? Take you where, m'lady? Fun old lady Agnes? Angus? Angs? I don't know. Duskull and Ralts. Nico and Joey. And you know what? I am gonna switch up the team every episode. We'll have some different combinations of people going out in front. I just wanted to, of course, lead with Nico and Joey, because it's Nico and Joey. So, I mean, why wouldn't I? And I've just been using Helping Hand on Nico's turn every time, just to ensure that, ensure that Joey kills, even though I know that he will every single time. And bye-bye, Ralts! Bye! And there we go. We're almost getting 100 experience per Pokemon, guys. Actually, if Hedwig levels up, I'm gonna laugh, because she's been getting more experience than everybody else. But how? Well... I'm not gonna go into how.
Perhaps it's high time that this old woman retire. It will be a relief.
Yeah, probably. Hello there! Area 10, Zone 10, Vanda. Hi, Wes. I've been waiting for you. Are you ready for serious training? Even though you saved me, a battle's a battle. Let's not waste any time. Oh snap, it's the dude that we saved. Wait, is this really the guy who... Is this the guy who, Darkim, like, attacked or whatever? Anyways, Zigzagoon and Whismur. Sir, I can see why you lost. Because, I mean, our starters, they started out at, like, what, level 26, 27-ish, I think? Espeon and Umbreon? And you're here with level... 18 and level 20 post-game, sir, so I can see why you failed, but anyway, Joey's gonna surf all over your face. Take that as you will. Down goes Zigzagoon. Slowly but surely, and Whismur, I don't think you're living because you just got crit, so bye-bye. Unless he's gonna surprise us and have a third Pokemon. Maybe? Do you? Oh, you do! You have a Skitty! Okay. Oh! Okay, sir. You have more Pokemon than I thought. In that case, we're gonna go for Psychic on Slakoth, and we're actually gonna Dragon Claw this Skitty, because I'm not just gonna spam Surf every time, even though that's what we've been doing so far. Down goes Slakoth. And with any luck, because Joey really hasn't been doing too good. You have another Pokemon? I didn't look at the Pokeball symbol or whatever when we started fighting this guy. Does he have six? I mean, that would make sense because he's an area leader. I just didn't realize that. But there we go. Joey actually got a kill with Dragon Claw. Okay, your last Pokemon is a Jigglypuff. And it's about to deflate. Don't you think it's kind of weird that Igglybuff and Jigglypuff eventually evolve into Wigglytuff? Because Igglybuff and Jigglypuff are like balloon Pokemon, but then Wigglytuff is just like this thing. Fantastic. Fantastic. You cleared Area 1. Congratulations, you really are talented. Now, go on. Someone will give you Poke Coupons in the break room. To the break room we go! I'll be in the break room in a few hours at work. And here we are. Oh yes, you have cleared Area 1, congratulations! Here are your Poke Coupons for surviving the Knockout Challenge. We won 100 Poke Coupons, which really isn't a lot. We're not gonna advance just yet. No. Stop. Okay, I'm just trying to go over here to save, my dude. So, you can come over here, you can heal your Pokemon by depositing them, although I'm pretty sure that they're already healed. I know Joey took 1 point of damage. Yeah, he's healed. So, they heal between areas. In fact, they might heal between fights that I don't remember, but... You have the option to deposit Pokemon if you want to, switch some out and stuff, and of course, to save, so... It's not gonna be too incredibly bad for us, I don't think. We're gonna leave Rui away from us for quite a while, so... It's gonna be a while before we see her again, is what I'm saying. Anyways, you can also use Abra to teleport to the main desk, like that guy said, if you want to. So, if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to leave a like and let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one next Monday, and I'll see you guys then.